Okay, so our last video, specific to the treadmill, is going to be annual maintenance. First thing you want to do when you're maintaining your treadmill is to give it an all-round inspection. Make sure it's turned off and look around for signs of wear and damage. One key point to look for is a flex at the front of the machine. Now, because the machine moves up and down, it's possible for the treadmill to run over its own flex and damage its own flex. Check nuts and bolts are tight, and also check HRM sensors to make sure they're not damaged, the buttons work, and especially the emergency stop button. Regarding the belt and board, specially inspect the belt on an annual basis, and you can do this by rotating it by hand if necessary to look at it closely. The board underneath the belt will typically fail towards the front third in the middle, and this is because this is where most people's feet land when they're running. At the same time, you want to lubricate your belt. Now, there's various lubricants you can use. Jim Weho supplies several. A spray-on one can be easier to use. What I like to do prior to applying the lubricant is to loosen the belt. You don't need to loosen both sides. If you loosen one side, insert your Allen key and turn 10 turns anti-clockwise. That way, this belt will become looser. You can gain good access and spray your lubricant underneath the belt. Try to avoid getting it here, and if you do, mop it up before you finish. When you finish, turn the Allen key 10 turns clockwise, which should bring your belt back to its original position. At the same time, you want to be checking the tension of your belt, alignment and tracking. All those can be adjusted, and if you look at the other videos we've done, they'll show you how to adjust those. If you get the chance, look underneath at the board and the mounting points, then you should be shock absorbers for this board, and check the condition of them. Further maintenance is under the motor hosing cover, which we look at now. Okay, so once your treadmill's inclined and the power's turned off, you can access under the hosing by removing the screws on either side. Generally, you have two on either side and then some on the front of the machine. Okay, so here we are underneath the hosing cover. I've inclined the treadmill prior to removing the cover to give us better access and also to allow access to the worm drive. Also, make sure the machine's turned off and unplugged when you do this. Just to orientate you, here we have AC motor, inverter, power supply, down here is a small incline board, and the incline motor. So what we're looking for here is to check the cables are all intact and not wearing. Check the tension of the belt. I should clean the area to remove dust and debris, as it often becomes very dirty in here and it can inhibit the cooling of the inverter. The key maintenance we want to do here is to lubricate this worm drive, and you can do that with spray-on lube grease. Just spray on a little bit towards the bottom, and as the treadmill lowers, it will spread the grease along the worm drive. The final item I like to check when I'm servicing a treadmill are the bearings. Now, there are four of these, two on the front roller, two on the rear roller. These can fail after being used. It's hard to actually check and feel them or visually inspect them. So I find the best thing is to run the treadmill at high speed and listen to see if there is a whine. It should be quite evident if they need changing. Okay, so that's what we recommend for annual maintenance on your treadmill. If it's being used intensively, you may want to conduct that maintenance more often. If you've got any queries, you can contact us via our website, www.lubrication.com.